Liverpool Super Club Cream is hosting one of the UK's biggest millennium parties. It's cost over £2 million and taken 8 months of planning to pull together. Over 1,000 workmen have been on site for a month at Liverpool's pierhead, building the biggest tent in the world, where over 26,000 clubbers will see in the new millennium. It's the most important gig Cream's managing director James Barton has ever staged.
Believe me, this beats sitting in the house with a couple of crates of lager and a couple of fucking sausage rolls, you know what I mean?
Tonight, Paul Oakenfold, Seb Fontaine, Pete Tong and Fatboy Slim have all got hectic schedules, travelling up and down the country to party like it's 1999.
How much sound? Kids like K's, come on. 2,000K of sound.
As the countdown continues, everything's coming together on schedule. James Barton and his team have less than 2 hours before the party of a lifetime kicks off.
We're just about to open gates. Ready to rock and roll.
December 31st, 1999 is a major fixture in all the super clubs' calendars, but none of their events have sold out. With tickets costing up to £130, some clubs have had to cancel, while others have dramatically scaled down their plans for the night.
The gates will be open any time now.
Just get the fucking gates open, let the kids in. We're open.
Cream is hosting three other events to mark the millennium. Another in Liverpool at Nation, plus nights in Cardiff and London. DJ Seb Fontaine's first gig tonight's in Cardiff, and then he's playing both Liverpool events. He's setting off from London for the 560-mile round trip.
The team is, squad is, as follows. We've got Vanessa.
Me bird.
We've got Alison, her sister, but who's also my PA for the moment. Hi, Ellie. And Simon, driver, and me. That's it, we can't take him enough.
Ex-bedroom DJ Paul Hillier's got a big night ahead of him too. First he's playing Gosh in Eastbourne, then he's driving up to London for a late gig at Brixton Academy. His fiancée Claire is worried he'll forget vital supplies.
I won't forget the beers, darling.
Right.
Come on, you go.
Right, and I've left your bath. I've left the water in the bath.
Okay.
All your clothes are ironed.
All right.
So I'll just go now.
See?
Right, here's the minibus keys. Where's
right.
The keys for
Clea?
Oh, in the boot.
You've gone.
I just need to get my bag.
Nia, Claire, Abby and Gemma are just four of the 26,000 clubbers who have paid £75 for a ticket to the pierhead. They're all students and have come for Pete Tong, Orbital and to pull as many boys as they can.
What you need is the resolution, Claire.
Since he won the bedroom DJ competition a few months ago, Paul Hillier's been on the fast track. He's already played Ibiza, Trade and Cream, but tonight's the highlight of his year.
I'm not really quite sure what to expect tonight, because I mean, it's the biggest night of the year and the biggest night ever, and it seems like 99% of people have decided they don't want to go out to a club this year. That's what it seems like anyway. So I think it's going to be a good time. I'm really looking forward to it, and I can't believe I'm playing Cream on New Year's Eve.
The party at Brixton Academy began after the pierhead, and multi-millionaire DJ Fatboy Slim started his evening here. He's playing Cardiff next and then two gigs in Liverpool. The club's not full, so he's decided to play his set in the foyer. Tonight, Pete Tong's essential selection is being broadcast live from a pub on the pierhead. Later, he's doing a two-hour essential mix in front of 26,000 clubbers.
Am I going to be back announcing Orbital? Because you're going to get... It's going to be a double whammy, because you're going to... No, because if I'm there at 12.30, Orbital finish, It's like, put your hands together for Orbital, people are going mad. It won't be quite the same as, and now we are live, I'll have to work out a little speech.
The best one is like, you know, say hello to everyone at home, and they all just go, it's like, you know what I mean?
Two huge Liverpool bands, The Lightning Seeds and Space, are playing before midnight. The lead guitarist of Space, Jamie Murphy, isn't sure their sound is what the clubbers will want.
It wasn't The Lightning Seeds, two of the biggest bands in Liverpool. I think, you know, we're gonna, a lot of the crowd are gonna be here in The Lightning Seeds, and the Stereo Phonics, but they've been really big this year as well, so, I mean, I know Orbital a lot of playing, I'm looking forward, to be honest, if it was me, I'm looking forward to seeing Orbital myself, you know what I mean? So I'd be into that, but I mean, I don't think it's going to be a total dance crowd. If it is, we're buggered.
I think we might have interrupted some of the regulars' normal night out. Somebody just came over and asked me to turn the music down. They're doing a pub quiz. We're going to be catching up with a few of the One World players for you over the next 2 hours. We've got the international Essential Mobile working overtime as we try and track down Danny Rambling in South Africa, Carl Cox on his way to Hawaii right now, Norman Cook and Judge Jules, who are all somewhere on this planet, promise. We are going to have a mad one.
Top name DJs for tonight's big parties have been booked for months. Seb Fontaine's arriving in Wales for his first Millennium gig.
You know what I love, right? Carl Cox, Sydney. Danny Rampling. Danny Rampling, South Africa. Seb Fontaine, Wales.
There's nothing wrong with Wales.
No, I love Wales. Cardiff's a great place.
Lightning Seeds founder Ian Brodie's a Liverpool legend. Cream took the gamble on booking bands tonight to give the Pierhead party a festival feel.
It's not work really, is it? You know what I mean? I mean, lucky enough to, you know, to do the thing that I love. So I think the idea of spending New Year's Eve doing a gig, which is what you love doing, you know, loads of people around you, you know, at a great party, it was dead appealing, yeah.
Judge Jules, how are you?
Ironically, Pete,
not quite as good as you. Well, I don't know about that. I've got to ask you a couple of things about tonight then. Firstly, can you tell me if this rumour's true? Have you and your wife Amanda got matching outfits?
We have got matching outfits.
I won my bet!
Can you believe that? She's just asked the security, keep an eye on the car. It's got all my makeup in it.
There was talk of gigs in Canada and Hong Kong for Paul Hillier tonight, but he's honouring a long-term commitment to play to a crowd of hundreds at Gosh in Eastbourne.
New Year's Eve at Gosh, and I'm on in about 15 minutes, so it's not rammed, but they're having a wicked time. It's going to be a good night, I think.
Tonight's not just about DJs and tunes, it's about pulling too.
My best chad line is tits out, that's it.
Okay, my best chad line is when I sit in a corner and I see a nice guy and I look at him and I go like this. And he looks and he walks over and I say, if I can make you come with my little finger, imagine what my whole body can do.
I don't do chad lines.
Definitely my best chad line is if I could arrange the alphabet, if I put I and you together.
Inside the main arena, Space are on stage. They're facing a massive audience of clubbers, and this is the moment of truth. The Lightning Seeds are on next, and for Ian Brodie, the adrenaline's starting to kick in.
Getting really nervous now. We're on in about 3 minutes or something. Just nervous, and I hope it's going to be really good.
DJ God of Gods, Paul Oakenfold's back at Nation, home of Cream in Liverpool, for his first gig of the night. The tickets here cost £99 each for 10 hours of full-on Millennium dance music. Pete Tong, Seb Fontaine and Fatboy Slim are all playing here as well as the Pierhead, where Oki's heading later. Tong's on a tight schedule. He's taking over from Oki at Nation, but before he leaves the pierhead, the lightning seeds are on and James Barton's showing off the main arena.
I didn't realise, because you only saw them from the back, from the pub. Yeah. I only saw them going between the venues. I didn't realise how many fucking people were there.
It's full.
Fucking thing's full. Fucking thing's full.
Seb's first gig is at Cardiff's ice rink. They've had to build a DJ booth specially for tonight, but it's not easy getting in. Next, Paul Oakenfold plays the gig of his life at the Pierhead. Pete Tong takes over at Nation. And Orbital's chimes ring in the new year. Oakenfold is the most famous DJ in the world. He's taken the sound of trance from South America to the Far East and back again. The music at the Pierhead's very varied, but everyone's got their favourite tune.
This year's favourite tune has to be Planet Perfecto, Bullet and Your Gun.
Favourite tune of 99 was Sasha Expander.
I don't know, well, there's been a lot of good tunes about, but probably a Starsky and Hutch remix, Breakbeat Era, fucking brilliant.
Best song of 99, well, we've got to say Millennium by Robbie Williams, haven't we seen this tonight?
My favourite song this year was I don't know the name, so I sing it. I don't know what it's called.
Cardiff's given Seb a great start to his night. Next up, the pierhead.
We've done Cardiff. Cardiff was really good, you know. The people were really, really nice and everything. It was really good in there. It's really G'd me up. So it's off to Liverpool now. We're going to spend our millennium in the service station.
Yeah.
It was good. Cardiff was great.
Yeah, Cardiff was good.
One down, two to go.
There are over 2,000 club nights happening around the country tonight. And with an hour to go to midnight, it's Paul Hillier's turn on the decks at Gosh in Eastbourne. Director of Communications, Jane Casey's been dealing with the press all night. This is her 10th interview.
We were really worried about mixing rock music and dance music. It's the first time it's ever been done, but it worked fantastically. People like Ian Brody were terrified going on stage, but they couldn't believe the reception they got. All the rock acts just loved it.
Brilliant. So are you looking forward to the rest of the night?
I am, but most importantly, I'm looking forward to staying in bed tomorrow.
Me too.
One of the people in Ian Brody's first band was Holly Johnson of Frankie Goes to Hollywood. Another was Cream's director of communications.
I've known Jane a long time. I used to be in a group with Jane, our first group, big in Japan. So when we were just nippers, so I've known her a long time.
Oki's whipped the crowd up to fever pitch. The new millennium is only 40 minutes away. Midnight gets closer, local clubber Maria has only just arrived at the pierhead. Even though it's 5 hours since the gates opened, there are still queues for the cloakrooms, but Maria just wants to party.
I've just been told my coat in. I'm being told to come here to this little shed. So we're going to come here and I'm going to wait for about half an hour. Well, my tunes are playing in there, but I'm standing out here freezing my tits off once again. I should have brought plasters to put on my tits and that was being all right, you know what I mean? I would have cooked them up. I would have felt a bit better then.
Orbital are playing the all-important Midnight Millennium moment. Paul Hartnell's attracting a lot of media attention, but he just wants to relax.
I'm full of nervous energy. I'm not crapping myself yet, but I know I will be soon. You know, I keep jumping on the spot and going, which means I'm nervous, really, deep down. I just want the time to, I don't like to wish my life away, but I just want it to be 11:30 now so I can just get on there and start, you know.
Okay, where do I think?
Claire's been putting off going to the toilet, but she can't wait any longer.
Second gig of the night, here we are at Cream in Liverpool.
Superstar DJ Pete Tong's the linchpin of Radio 1's Millennium coverage, a 28-hour dance music marathon featuring 5 midnights worldwide. After his set at Nation, he's going back to the Pierhead for a live essential mix in front of 26,000 clubbers. We'll be right back. the time tonight's over, clubbers on the pierhead will have drunk more than 500 bottles of champagne, 40,000 cans of soft drink, 60,000 cans of beer, and over 80,000 bottles of mineral water.
We're the guinea pigs. Do you know what I mean? It's like that. Maybe that's James Barton's trick. You know, it's like, right, let's get the most electronic band we can find and make them play between 11:30 and 12:30, and they'll all be laughing from the back. You know, but you know, so we'll see. We'll see if all my equipment, you know, when we're counting down, it all just goes ah and freezes at 12 o'clock. Then it's straight over to Pete Tong on the ones and twos, I think. But he will be essential then, won't he?
Maria still hasn't heard a DJ.
Yeah, there's someone there, but excuse me, I need the toilet desperately. Can I just? I know you do, but I'm a girl, and
there's
girls.
Someone over there, look.
No, but they're not, and I can't do that.
Someone coming out.
Yeah, but someone's going in. Look, New Year, Millennium, and all that. You can't.
No. 10 minutes. I won't be in 2 seconds.
No, you will.
Oh,
and I don't really worry. Go to the toilet.
I'm quicker than
you. All right then, let's see how quick you're in.
Orbital are about to take to the stage. It's just over half an hour to midnight and they've got a hard act to follow. Midnight's getting closer and Claire's getting in some snogging practice. From Orbital's really feeling the pressure. He's never played a gig before where hitting midnight is so crucial. Chime must start on the stroke of midnight. Abby, Nia, Claire and Gemma are trying to get through to their mums for the last time this century.
What did she say?
I think she's on the pool.
Hello.
Hey. Oh, seriously, I think my mother is on the pool and I've not even snogged yet. But I'm not going to.
Because you've got a boyfriend.
Yeah,
hello.
Of course.
With just half an hour to midnight, Okies push the crowd to the edge.
Enjoyed myself, you know, the way you just get in one place and enjoy yourself and let off. I haven't done that yet. You know what, I'm still warming up. I still need to warm up, so I'm going to go in the bugged out tent for 10 minutes and let off. Hey!
Okie's ecstatic. It's been one of his best gigs ever. Clubbers have flocked to Liverpool from all over Britain, and they're here for one thing, dancing. Barton chose Orbital to play at midnight because they were one of the first bands he ever booked when he started out. Their anthem, Chime, is going to welcome the 21st century in Liverpool. 20 minutes to the millennium, Claire's getting in some more midnight practice. Maria's finally made it inside, and now her night's really started.
Right, we've got about 14 minutes to the year 2000, and we've got about 12 miles to the next service station, which is our destination of choice to bring in the new century.
There's less than 15 minutes to go. James Barton's bringing in the bubbly backstage, Pete Tong's on the decks at Nation, Seb Fontaine's on the road, and Paul Hillier's on a roll at Gosh.
Minutes to go.
I can't believe we're spending our New Year
time at service
station.
Fire away. Oh no, gone. Oh Jesus! You've ruined my millennium!
Oh, you've ruined the millennium now!
Ness! My millennium's ruined! Keep your tongue in. I'm in a really good mood. I feel like I'm close to nature.
see me. I've got a King's record in one hand and a bottle of vodka in the other. Happy New Year, I'm off, bye.
Next, Fatboy Slim gets crowned King of Liverpool. Seb Fontaine takes over on the pierhead. And it all gets too much for Nia. Tong's back at the pierhead for the first essential mix of the 21st century. It's being broadcast to millions around the world, live from Liverpool in front of 26,000 clubbers.
Say Happy New Year!
Come on, Pete. So far, the Millennium has been brilliant. It's been really, I mean, it sounds funny that we're in a car, you know, everyone's going, oh, it was such and such. But I mean, Radio 1 has been brilliant tonight. They've gone all round, you know, they've done loads of different New Year's Eves, loads of midnights. They've done loads of sets. It's actually been really cool listening to loads of DJs, you know, who I'm kind of friends with, but also get on with. I mean, Pete's probably got the best radio show in the world. And, you know, so to sit here listening to Pete now coming in at the place that we're just about to play, you know, and it sounds brilliant. It's really cool. We are here. Listen to it. This is great.
Say Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, everyone.
Paul Hillier's in a hurry. His girlfriend Claire's rented a minibus to drive him and their friends the 60 miles to Brixton Academy.
Right, everyone in?
Yeah. Everyone, everyone sorted?
Sorted.
Happy New Year, you nutters! Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm the star,
eh? You are the star. See, behind every hard-working man... No, behind every successful man is a hard-working woman. What can I say? Mwah! Where'd I be without you, darling?
Who's playing for you for?
Sasha. And then Tong after me, and then
how
I'm playing.
Play?
I don't know. I know he's finishing at 5:30. I'll start at 5:30 till Tong gets there. And then Pete Tong plays for about an hour, and then I play till the end after that.
Alright then, innit?
Sasha and Pete Tong either side? Yeah, you can't get much better than that. You know what I mean?
After 280 miles and 4 hours on the road, Seb Fontaine's arrived in Liverpool.
It's now 2 a.m, and we're just about to take over from Tongi, who you can hear in the distance. It sounds about 26,000 people. You know, I'm really excited. I'm really, really excited. It's going to be really good. I just want to get on now.
In the Liggers tent on the pierhead, it's all got a bit too much for Nia. Abby's just pulled. Claire and Gemma are up for a big night out. But unfortunately for Nia, she's peaked too soon.
No, I'm really late. Oh no, I've got to get in. Pete's really late. He's moaning already.
We start putting the money away for us. Well, I mean, this is a joke. This is for the cash.
Hello. took over from Paul Oakenfold as Queen resident 12 months ago, Seb Fontaine's had the best year of his life. After this gig at the Pierhead, he's ending his night in Liverpool with a set at Nation. While the night's winding down for some, Paul Hillier's arrived in Brixton. It's the biggest gig of his life, and he's in for some surprise superstar treatment in his own dressing room.
Are we all getting dressed in the
shower? The glamour of it all. Fat Boy Slim, Craig Richards, Sasha,
Pink Tong, and some bloke called Paul Hillier.
Clubbers travel hundreds of miles every weekend to hear their favourite DJs.
Definitely last year, favourite DJ, Seb Fontaine. He's fast, he's hard, he knows how to play, and he just fucking takes it out to the limit. And if you want to dance, he'll make you dance all night long. You don't need anything else, Seb Fontaine will do it all for you. He's the best.
Fatboy Slim, without doubt, he's just brilliant.
Paul Oakenfold, he's top quality. And then there's Pete Tong.
Probably Carl Cox at Ultimate Bass 2. But John Digweed at Renaissance was just mental. It's really intelligent. It's great. Great stuff. I'm not a big fan of trance, but tonight Oki's been out of this world.
And it's alright to leave all your cans and everything in.
I can't do that one, the other one.
I love it, it's like, I mean, you know, you don't expect it. But...
Look at the vultures, look at them all.
That was for me and you're drinking it all.
Do you want some vultures?
No,
yeah, I have some
orange
juice.
Oh, we're drinking it for you. Absolutely.
It's
really nice of them, though, isn't it?
Of course it is. Unbelievable.
So they do that for everyone?
Well, I guess so. I wasn't expecting that at all.
You're just the man, Paul.
Well, here we are. We're standing here. It's Millennium Evening. It's about 4.20 in the morning. I'm on at 4.30 in Nation. We've just done the Pierhead, which, I mean, you know, you'd have seen by now, was probably one of the best gigs of my life. It was unbelievable. There's like 22,000 people. Seb, I'm doing something here. And I'm doing...
Seb,
I'm in the middle of doing
something. I know so still.
Listen, Happy New Year. Nice
yeah,
to meet you.
All the best, oh, man.
Look after yourself. Cool. Nice, nice to meet you too. Happy New Year.
Hey!
Hi, my name is German.
Don't be drunk, Jan.
Oh. Hi, baby.
Me and I are drunk. Baby. Be drunk, but don't be this drunk. Oh, bless her.
Seb's back where he belongs, his room at Nation. When he finishes tonight, he'll have played for 6 hours, and then he's ready to party. It's 5 o'clock, and the original DJ superstar Sasha has been keeping the crowd going at Brixton. Taking over from him is a big challenge for Paul Hillier. After 9 hours on the Pierhead, Abby, Gemma, Nia and Claire don't know whether to carry on or not. Nia was sick, Claire snogged 5 different blokes, Abby's got a load of phone numbers and Gemma's danced all night.
And did we pull?
We pulled like funny
babies.
We were brilliant.
Handmade pussies.
We were brilliant.
Excuse me, the hustler, please.
The hustler.
Excuse me, pure killer.
Get out.
Pure killer.
Oh, should we go home now?
Nah.
after the biggest gamble of his life, the clubbers give their verdict on James Barton's party of a lifetime.
Definitely the best things and worst things tonight is it's bringing the entire UK together as a whole group.
And everybody else, look, he's got the lightning seeds here. Absolutely. You can't be in a better place. If you're not here, you've missed out.
The worst thing is it should happen more often.
Well, the worst thing is the price.
The weather's okay, not too bad. And the queuing went on for a bit too long, but everything else is absolutely brilliant. Food stalls, music, the crowd, it's amazing.
Travelling up from London to Liverpool was a bit of a nightmare.
The worst thing about tonight has been cleaning from the fucking toilet.
Yeah, the worst thing about tonight has been...
You pay 70 quid for a ticket and the loser rank.
Okay, the best thing about tonight is that there's so many people here, it's a really good buzz. There's loads of great bands, DJs playing.
Best part was Orbital Live at midnight.
The best thing is the atmosphere, and the worst thing is feet.
The feet are killing.
Killing.
The best part was Paul Oakenfold. The worst part is now.
Sasha is one of Paul Hillier's heroes, and Paul wants to start his set well to impress him and the Brixton Academy crowd. Heavyweight DJ lineup going right to the end. It's 6:30 in the morning and the pierhead still packed as Fatboy Slim hits the decks.
Liverpool, the Millennium, Steve and Rick Lane, we're here at the business, Sky One, love it, massive!
The millennium's over, but the story continues. James Barton's planning an internet business and is opening a new club. Seb Fontaine's been booked to play South Africa, Australia and South America this spring. And then he's finally going to marry Vanessa. Paul Hillier is splitting his time between DJing and working in a record shop. He releases his first track soon. And Jane Casey... Well, she's just Jane Casey.